Hey, what's up guys? Nuno here. Lumion just released their newest version, 12.3. And in today's video, I'm going to go through the best features available in this release. And by the way, stick around until the end of the video, because I'm going to let you know a little spoiler that Lumion just showed in their official 12.3 release video. So without further ado, let's get started. So let's start this video with the first feature, which by the way, I already predicted they will do this. It's the custom surface decals. So this means that now you are able to load up your custom surface decals and you can do many creative things with this. And I'm going to show you right now how does this work. So you go here to the effects and you'll find here one new one, which is called custom decal. You see the Lumion logo here. You select and you place it here. And this decal now, you can, it will show first like this with the show more options hidden. So you click it and now you can load the color map, normal map, gloss map, and also reflectivity map. You also have the other properties like you had before, like for the transparency of this decal, the range and orientation. So let's load here some texture so we can see. For these decals, you can go to various sites to get decals. You can even go to this site, Free Pick. On this one, you can even download for free some elements, and you can just search for pattern, for example, if you want to make some wall patterns. And you have many here that you can select and download. And I'm going to show you this soon, but let me just show you another way that you can get some decals. You could go to a site called textures.com. And here you'll find on the left side decals, and you have a lot of them categorized by damage, leaking, patched wall, stained. So, and when you click, you'll see huge variety of elements that you can load into Lumion. You can download here and load into Lumion. And you also have Polygon. As you know, Polygon, in my opinion, is one of the best sites to get your PBR materials, and not just PBR materials. You also have 3D models here and HDRIs. So. And of course, you have decals. So you can click here, decals, and you have these categorized as well. You can go to street, for example, and you have some street patches, some street signs, some rubbish, and all of this you can load as a surface decal. Moving again to Lumion. So when you click here, load color map, I already have here one that I downloaded from FreePick, and I'm going to load it. And now I'm just going to scale it. So it occupies the whole wall, I think something like this, maybe. Then I'm just going to drag like this, more or less, and move it up so it doesn't go on top of the baseboard here. And you can see that it's catching a little bit of the curtain as well, and even here of this ceiling. So. We can fix this by reducing the range to the minimum, okay. And you will notice that it even catches the properties of the wall. So a wall usually has this texture to it, and it keeps this texture, keeps the normal map of the base wall. And you can, of course, blend them. This doesn't have normal maps, but you could blend them. Can blend the glossiness, so if you don't want to have such glossiness, you can reduce here, and also the reflectivity. So then after this, you can take a render, and the render will look like this. This is the before image, and this one is after applying our surface decal. By the way, you can be very creative with this. So I have your Photoshop, and I'm just going to load the brush tool. And with this brush tool, I'm just selecting a random brush. This will be something very random that I'm going to create here. And we can create on a new layer because we want this with transparency. And just select some random color. And I'll start painting like this. Something very, very creative. And maybe a little bit of blue, something like this. This will be a great work of art. Something like yellow. Okay, then you can even select another type of brush. Let's select this one, for example. Okay, something like this, super creative. And then you can disable the background layer and we can save this as a PNG. So PNG, and I already have this one, I'm going to save it on top. Okay, now I'm going to go here to this surface and just going to load the different one. And for this case, I'm going to make it a little bit smaller. Maybe the size of the bed. And as you can see, it still blends with the normals of the base texture of the wall. For this one, maybe I can decrease a little bit like this. And now let's see how this will look in the render. And so this is how it looks. Of course, this was something very random that I just did, but you can see the potential of this tool. Moving to feature number two is volumetric lights for Omni lights. So in the previous version in Lumion 12, we were introduced to this volumetric light effect for spotlights, but now we also have it for Omni lights. And to make this, it's very simple. You just select any Omni light that you have on your scene, and then you go to add a new effect on the render mode. And you have here, even on the featured already, you have volumetric lights. And on this volumetric lights, first we'll select which light we want. So in my case, it's this one. Go back here. And we can select here how dense it's this effect, the intensity, and the fall off. So I'm just going to take a render. And this is the final result. As you can see, it's useful to give a little bit more dimension to some types of light, certain type of scene that you want to create. It's nice to have this option as well on the Omni lights. By the way, I didn't forget about the spoiler for the Lumion 12.3 official video, so stick around. And the next feature is drag and drop models. And so you can see that I have here this file, and I'm just simply going to drag and drop. You have to have the window of Lumion. Select the window, right? Select the build mode, and now you can drag and drop like this, and it will go directly to the import window. So, and you can leave it like this, and it will start importing your model. And if you want to know how to create realistic 3D renders, I have a free training for that. I'll leave a link in the top right corner and also in the description below this video. And moving to number three is new animated nature. So now they had a new animated nature, and the majority of them was for these widths. When you go to nature and you'll see widths. So now if you add a couple of them randomly here, you will see immediately that they all have some animation to them with the wind. So if I go here now, increase the wind speed. So now you can see that these widths will also be affected by the wind, giving it a more realistic look when we are making video. Feature number five is waxiness and transparency properties. And this goes for the material. And we have two properties in the material, which is one is waxiness, another is transparency. Transparency is how transparent any material is. And the waxiness is usually for the subsurface scattering effect. And this effect is usually, if you pointed, for example, a light into your fingers, you'll see that they become red because the light is still passing through. Actually, I have here my phone and you can see this effect more or less now. So you can see that it becomes a little bit red and the light is passing through your skin. And so it causes this effect. And this waxiness is creating a little bit more or less like that. And before you could only control one or another separate, either the waxiness or the transparency. But now in this version, you can go to any curtain and go to transparency and you'll find waxiness and transparency. So you can now control both. So if you leave, let's say that you leave transparency all the way on and then waxiness both in the middle and you take a render. By the way, I'm just using here the default settings of this scene. So this is how it would look, the scene, with the waxiness and the transparency half-half. And if I go here and change it to, let's see, waxiness all the way up and then transparency just, let's say 20%. Let's see the effect. So you can see the difference, right? This is the before and this is the after. So it's good that you can now control both these properties instead of just being one or another. And next feature is render multiple photo sets. And when you go to render, if you go to photo set, right now I have just these ones. Why? Because each photo set is this. You have these slots, right? These 10 slots, but you can click here, two, and you have photo set two. So if I click like this, okay. Now if I go to render, you'll find here as well, photo set one, photo set two. And you can render all of these photo sets in one go. Before you couldn't do this, you could just render each photo set. So basically 10 renders of each time. Next one is custom license plates. Again, with the custom surface decals, now you can also add your license plates. So if you add any car here on the scene, select this one, you can here license plate. So you can select any license plate. So let's say from Germany. Okay, now I have a license plate, or you can go here custom and you can select here, add any material to this. So it could be a license plate or it could be something else, but the purpose is to use for license plates. But again, you can go here and click add, and I could select that decal that I used before, for example. And now it's not showing up because you have two textures. Usually it's for front and rear, but just going to delete this one. And now we can see here, and then you can adjust, of course, as well, the dimensions of this license plate. And if you want to learn more about Lumion, I do have a course for that, and I'll give a link in the top right corner and also in the description below this video. And the last feature is new example projects. And I really like the new example projects, especially this one, the streetscape. You have a lot of detail here, and I'm actually going to start with this one. I'm going to load it up. So here's the project. And as you can see, it has a lot of detail. Even the materials are quite good. And not only that, you have a lot to explore on this scene. And even here, you see a lot of scenes like for sunset, for cloudy day, dawn, aerial view. So I think it's worth to have a look into these new scenes. And by the way, speaking of the spoiler from the Lumion 12.3 official video, I'm just going to play it a little bit to see if you can guess what it is. So did you see anything here? So I'm just going to play it again. Okay, we can go back. And if I go back here, we can see this license plate. It's a little bit different, right? It says Lum 13 RTX. So maybe this means that in Lumion 13, we'll finally have the RTX that a lot of people are asking for. Of course, this is just a spoiler. I don't know if it's going to be there or not. We still have a couple of months until the Lumion 13 gets released. But until then, we have this little spoiler. And let's see if finally it gets the RTX that many people are asking for. But let me know what you think. Did you see this spoiler on the video? And do you think that Lumion 13 will finally have the RTX? Let me know in the comments below. I hope you enjoyed this video. Don't forget to subscribe and let me know in the comments what you think of this new release. And I'll see you in the next one.